Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? I hope you all are excellent and very safe at home. Today we will see Beehive, from Beehive, one poem that is A Legend of Northland. A Legend of Northland. Okay? Legend means what? Legend means old. Old means very traditional. Okay, very old, very traditional. So we will see that poem, A Legend of Northland, written by Folk Carey. Written by Folk Carey is a lady. Okay, she is a poetess. She has written this poem. Folk Carey, born on 4th September 1824. 1824, born in 4th of September 1824, was an American poetess and the younger sisters of Alice Carey. Younger sisters of Alice Carey. Alice and Folk, these two sisters, they had written many poems, few poems, okay, these two, and they have published together, okay. These sisters co-published poems in 1849 and then each went to publish volumes in their own. Carey occasionally attended, not regularly, but occasionally she attended her school education. She often had to work at home and hence was largely self-educated. Her mother died in 1835 and 2 years later her father married again. Forbes died of hepatitis and was buried in New York. She died on 31st July 1871 and was buried in New York. After the death of both the sisters, a joint anthology of their poems was also completed. So, A Legend of Northland, written by Folk Carey. Okay, we'll see. Now, today we'll see the short summary of this poem. What is that? The Legend of Northland. Just now I said legend, old, traditional. Okay, Legend of Northland. Northland near the North Pole. Okay, there we see very cold, as that North Pole is very near, so that region is very cold region. Very few months, few days they can see sun rays. Okay, or otherwise always everywhere snowfall and everywhere cold region. So this is, and what is the theme, central idea of this poem? Okay, what is the central idea of this poem? This poem puts forth the idea that we should not be selfish. This poem tells us that we should not be selfish and always help the needy. Yes, dear children, we must see in which conditions the others are. Those who come to us for need, not only by giving money, but in any, by giving moral support, by giving one smile, by giving one, you know, one day's meal, or any types of help. It is not at all necessary always give money by help the needy people. Okay, but do live your life, you know, selflessly, selfishlessly. Understand, that is very important. That only this the central idea of the poem puts forth, the idea that we should not be selfish and always help the needy. And always help the needy. We never say that, no, I don't have this with me. We see, as a human being, we don't know when our time will come to take help from others. So be always lending hand. Okay, a selfish person has no satisfaction in life. The people, those who are selfish, they don't have any satisfaction in their life. You just see that. Take experience of that. When you give anything, even our small knowledge also, that day we feel very happy. You might have observed, you might have experienced this experience. Understand these, like these small, small examples, small, small experience, that whenever we give anything or share anything with others, and especially the needy people, we feel very happy. That day we feel very happy. Understand? So the hearing, a selfish person has no satisfaction in life. The other thing is this, this poem is a folk tale passed down from one generation to another generation. This is a ballad, you know. This is a ballad. Ballad means, you know, a song, a story written in a song, in song way. Understand? Story we always say in the passages, but these passages, as it is a poem or a song. So this is a ballad, okay. And this poem tells us a story not to be selfish, and if we will be selfish, what happens with us? As it is, there is no satisfaction. So that is especially, the story is written for the children, and this story goes generation to generation. See, here is a folk tale passed down from one generation to another, which teaches us not to be selfish. Which teaches us not to be selfish. Teaches us not to be selfish. And it is made to be read by a small children. Especially they have meant for a small children. Okay. So the theme we understood. So what story they have given in the form of poem. So we'll see the summary. This is this poem is a folk passed down from one generation to another, which teaches us not to be selfish. It is meant to be read by small children. And this, as this Northland, the legend of Northland, the place where the North Poles are very nearby there. The Northland is a very, very cold region. Okay, covered with the snow. Its closeness to the North Pole. That region is near to North Pole. That's why it's everywhere. Snow is there. Closeness to the North Pole gives us a place, a cold weather with very few hours of sunlight. Only few hours, not much. Everywhere, snow only, the cold region. The poetess has written that here the hours of day, you know, as in the winter, if you see here also, when we see in the winter, nights are long and days are small. So in that, they see the sunlight, sun rays or sun, we can say sunlight. So it's very difficult to sleep, you know, whole night, the long night, it is unable to sleep. It's very difficult, hardly 8 hours, 9 hours, 10 hours we can sleep. If the night is long, it's unable to sleep. Those people, they are unable to sleep there. Okay, then sunlight. The poetess has written that here the hours of day are few and the nights are long in winter. The people are unable to spend the whole night sleeping. Unable to whole night sleeping over there. The poetess doesn't believe in the authenticity of the story, yet she is tempted to share this story to others. What is that story then? The story is there. You know, one Saint Peter, Saint, S-A-I-N-T, Saint, you know, the Saint means Santalo, Santa Mahatmalo, you know, Saint, the Saint, the we say here in Maharashtra, we say, okay, in India we say Sant Kabir, Sant Namdev, Sant Tukaram. So this Sant, Sant in English we say that Saint, S-A-I-N-T, Saint, Saint Peter. In those areas, European countries, St. Peter, St. George, St. Luke, St. Mark, St. John's, their names are there and they are saints. And these people, like us, Sant, you know, Sant Tukaram, Sant Namadev and all, they are devoted, devoted towards God. And they always do the social work or related with God. The same thing in the northern, the European countries also, those who were sent, they were doing that. Those who were only devoted to God or devoted their life to do the social work. So once in this poem, the short story, as we have seen this is a small story, and that story goes to generation to generation. So once Saint Peter was on the round to see how the people are staying, and while he was taking round, these people they go and see there, and if anybody needy people are there, they give from their side. Okay, now so this there in the churches and all, in the metropolitan city, you might have seen the father. Okay, so like this they help. So, but they are the Sant, they are the saints people, saint. So once he was roaming, taking round in the village or in the city, that time he was feeling very hungry. When he felt very hungry, so he saw one small, you know, house, and he went there and asked that little lady, "I am very hungry, can you?" And that time she was baking cake. You know, the European countries, they always specially eat cake, and she was baking cake. When Saint Peter asked her that, "I am very hungry, can you give me bread to eat?" So she made very tiny, you know, baking very small round that, and she baked that dough, and when she took taken out that dough, she felt that no, this is not a small, this is a very big cake. So again she has taken the another dough means that जो चीज से हम लोग केक बनाते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ डव, यू नो, आटा जो रहता है ना, मटेरियल. देन अगेन शी मेड एंड थिनर शी टुक, ओके ना, थिनर शी टुक एंड अगेन शी बेक. देन व्हेन शी सॉ दैट, अगेन शी सॉ दैट कि नो, दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी बिग. And 2, 3, 4 times she has done the same thing, and she was at last like a wafer, you know, when we eat wafer like a paper, this much, you know, thin, like that she made. But when this Saint Peter saw that, he got very angry. And she, what he said that he angry, then what he said, he said that she was selfish and did not even give him a small piece. So selfish. No, I want this, all the things she only want. And as the scent has come in her house, she did not feel that to give her. Then Saint Peter got very angry, and she was selfish and did not even give him a small piece. Okay, and Saint Peter cursed her. You know, sharp dena kehte hain. Jab unko bahut gussa aa gaya, he cursed her, and she was not fit. He cursed that her and told her that she was not fit to live in human form and enjoy food and warmth. So much selfish. She does not caliber. She doesn't have that. She fit for you as a human being. And to food and warmth, you know, those region warmth is very important, because cold region is there. They always keep a heater in their house, you know. Then he cursed, as he did not get even a single piece of cake, as he was very hungry from whole day and she didn't fit. So he cursed and said that she was not fit to live in human form and enjoy food and warmth. He turned her, Saint Peter gave curse and turn her into a woodpecker. Woodpecker, you know, we see in the forest and all, especially we see in the forest woodpecker having very big beak, and they peek the whole stem, dry stem, okay, the whole tree, okay, into a woodpecker who has bore a hole, H-O-L-E, hole in hard and dry wood to get his scant food, to search food, because she did not give, you know, food to needy people. When father, that Saint Peter has come, she did not, and he goes that you will go whole year in your life that you will search food easily, you will not get food. So that's why we always see by searching woodpeckers, they sit on the stem, and you know that is a story, as we said in the beginning, that's a story. Then they have to see, they have to cut the wood. That's a woodpecker, wood, understand? And woodpecker who has to bore a hole in hard and dry wood to get its food. The woman was punished for her greed and selfishness. The woman was punished because she has not. And he has cursed as she did not give food. So you will also scant. You will roam everywhere to get small food also, you know. So selfishness, as we see there, selfish person has no satisfaction in life. What is the main point of this story, of this poem then? This poem is from Northland, okay? The Northland is a cold region. The nights are longer and compared to days, especially in winter. Once Saint Peter, just now what I said, once Saint Peter stopped at an old lady's cottage because he was feeling hungry. The lady was baking cake on her hearth, H-E-A-R, means in her, where the place is there where the cakes bake, okay? When Saint Peter asked for one of her cakes, she tried to make a tiny cake for him, but when she baked it, she found it too large to give it to him. She tried to bake two more times, but even the smallest of cakes seemed too large for her. Such a greedy behavior of the lady annoyed the angry Saint Peter. Okay, he cursed her saying that she was far too selfish to be a human, to have food, shelter and fire to keep her warm. Okay, thus she was transformed into woodpecker. All her clothes except her scarlet cap were gone as she went up in the chimney. As soon as, you know, the chimney, they keep the chimneys, and as soon as the Saint Peter cursed, she transformed into woodpecker and she flew away. It flew away from the chimney and outside chimney and flew out of the top. Every schoolboy is said to have seen her in the forest boring into wood for food. This is a small story they have given in the poem A Legend of the Northland, written by Fort Carey. So the detailed explanation we'll see in the next lecture. I hope, dear children, you understood this story very much. You read that and you find out the difficult new words for you, underline that, write the meaning in that, and read once again that this ballad story in the poem form, in the song form written by Pope Carey. Thank you and have a nice day.